the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon.
Yeah.
As we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, continuing in our journey of Lent, we remember in a special way, of course, all those affected by the coronavirus pandemic, but also all those members of each of your families who may be ill or suffering in one way or another. And we call upon the Lord, asking for his mercy, his forgiveness for us, and that his presence be felt in the lives of all those who need him. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, to heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whose wondrous grace we are enriched with every blessing, grant us so to pass from former ways to newness of life, that we may be made ready for the glory of the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. In Babylon lived a man named Joachim, who married a very beautiful and God-fearing woman, Susanna, the daughter of her people. Her pious parents had trained the daughter according to the law of Moses. Joachim was very rich. He had a garden in his house, and the Jews had recourse to him often because he was the most respected of them all. That year, two elders of the people were appointed judges, whom the Lord said, "Wickedness has come out of Babylon," from the elders who were to govern the people as judges. These men, to whom all brought their cases, frequented the house of Joachim. When the people left at noon, Susanna used to enter her husband's garden for a walk. When the old men saw her enter every day for a walk, they began to lust her. They suppressed their consciences. They would not allow their eyes to look to heaven, and did not keep in mind just judgments. One day, while they were waiting for the right moment, she entered the garden as usual, two maids only. She decided to bathe if the weather was warm. Nobody else was there except the two elders who had hidden themselves and were watching her. "Bring me oil and soap," she said to the maids, "and shut the garden doors while I bathe." As soon as the maids had left, the two old men got up and hurried to her. "Look," they said, "the garden's doors are shut and no one can see us. Give in to our desire and lie with us. If you refuse, we will testify against you that you dismissed your maid because a young man is here with you." "I am completely trapped," Susanna wrote. "If I yield, it will be my death. If I refuse, I cannot escape your power. Yet it is better for me to fall into your power without guilt than to sin before the Lord." Then Susanna shrieked, the old man also shouted, as one of them ran to open the garden doors. When the people in the house heard the cries of the garden, they rushed in by the side gate to see what had happened. At the accusations by the old men, the servants felt very much ashamed, for never had any such thing been said about Susanna. When the people came to her husband Joachim the next day, the two wicked elders also came, fully determined to put Susanna to death. Before all the people, they ordered, "Send for Susanna, the daughter of Hoboken, the wife of Joachim." When she was sent for, she came with her parents, children, and all her relatives. All the relatives of the elders were weeping. In the midst of the people, the two elders rose up and laid their hands on her head. Through tears, she looked up to heaven, for she trusted the Lord wholeheartedly. The elders made this accusation: "As we were walking in the garden alone, this woman entered with two girls and shut the doors of the garden, dismissing the girls. The young man who was hidden there came and lay with her. When we, in a corner of the garden, saw this crime, we ran toward him. We saw the light together that the man could not hold because he was stronger than we. He opened the doors and ran off. Then we seized her and asked who the young man was, but she refused to tell us. We testified to this. The assembly believed him, since they were others to judge the people, and they condemned her to death. But Susanna cried aloud, "O eternal God, you know what is hidden, and you are aware of all things before they come to be. You know that they have testified falsely against me. Here I am about to die, though I have done none of these things with which these wicked men have charged me." The Lord heard her prayer. As she was being led to execution, God stirred up the Holy Spirit of a young boy named David, and he cried aloud, "I will have no part in the death of this woman." All the people turned and asked him, "What is this you are saying?" He stood in their midst and continued, "Are you such fools, O children of Israel? To condemn a woman of Israel without examination and without clear evidence? Return to court, for they have testified falsely against her." Then all the people returned in haste. To Daniel the elder said, "Come, sit with us and inform us, since God has given you the prestige of old age." But he replied, "Separate these two far from each other that I may examine." After they were separated from one another, he called one of them and said, "How you have grown evil with age. Now, have your past sins come to term, passing unjust sentences, condemning the innocent, and freeing the guilty, although the Lord says, 'The innocent and the just you shall not put to death.' Now, then, if you were a witness, tell me, under what tree you saw them together?" "Under a mastic tree," he answered. Daniel replied, "Your fine lie has cost you your head, for the angel of God shall receive the sentence from him and split you in two." Putting him to one side, he ordered the other one to be brought. Daniel said to him, "Offspring of Canaan, not of Judah, beauty has seduced you. Lust has subverted your conscience. This is how you acted with the daughters of Israel, and in their fear they yielded to you. But a daughter of Judah did not tolerate your wickedness. Now, then, tell me, under what tree you surprised them together?" "Under an oak," he said. Daniel replied, "Your fine line has cost you also your head, for the angel of God waits with a sword to cut you in two, so as to make an end of you both." The whole assembly cried aloud, blessing God who saves those who hope in him. They rose up against the two elders, for by their own words Daniel had convicted them of perjury. According to the law of Moses, they inflicted on them the penalty they had plotted to impose on their neighbor. They put them to death. Thus was innocent blood spared that day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial song. "Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side."
Even though
I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. With your rod and your staff that give me courage.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side.
You spread the tables before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. Even though I
reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went to the Mount of Olives, but earlier, when he arrived again in the temple area, and all the people started coming to him, and he sat down and taught them. Then the scribes and Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery, and made her stand in the middle. They said to him, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. Now in the law, Moses commanded us to stone such women. So what do you say?" They sent this to test him, so that they could have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and began to write on the ground with his finger. But when they continued asking him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let the one of you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at him." Again he bent down and wrote on the ground, and in response they went away one by one, beginning with the elders. So he was left alone with the woman before him. Then Jesus straightened up and said to her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She replied, "No one, sir." Then Jesus said to her, "Neither do I condemn you. Go, and from now on, do not sin anymore." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We hear today in sacred scripture how there are accounts of two women. One that was who was the victim of injustice until young Daniel came up to speak for her, and the other who was supposedly a sinner caught in the act of adultery, but was seized upon by self-righteous people who felt that they were better than her, they had sinned as she did, and were so intent on stoning her in accordance with the law. Stoning her to death until Jesus comes on the scene and brings real justice, which is the only justice that we can have truly in God's justice, Jesus' justice. And so we see how Jesus releases the woman from her sin with only the admonition, "Sin no more," because she obviously was repentant. She looked for him to help. Commentaries of scripture and some scripture scholars tell us that these acts we hear twice recited about Jesus stooping to the ground and writing in the sand could have been one of two things: that he was showing them how disinterested he was in their righteousness and their claims against this woman and holding themselves above her, or that he was actually writing in the sand some of the various sins committed by those gathered around with stones in their hands, ready to kill her. And so once they witnessed this, they saw that they too were sinners and walked away. We're called to do the same, to acknowledge, to recognize our sins, and Lent is the time for us to continue to do that. And in repentance, sincerely, turn to the Lord Jesus. And he will release us from our sins too. But we have to be sincere. We have to be also honest and not seek to cleanse ourselves, rid ourselves of sin, or beg forgiveness for our sins, and yet be so quick to accuse another, ridicule another, bring harm upon another, because they The intention of Mass today that I pray on this Monday will be for all of you at home, who in your own ways of suffering and for all of your families. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that preparing to celebrate the holy mysteries, we may bring before you as the fruit of bodily penance a joyful purity of heart through Christ our Lord.
In our name.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit,
lift up your hearts.
We've lifted up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty. Since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed in the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our cardinal archbishop, and all the clergy and religious. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saints Peter and Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace with the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am the burden of your sin and your fear. To let us say, Lord, my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Strengthened by the blessing of our sacraments, we pray, O Lord, that through them we may constantly be cleansed of our faults, and by following Christ, hasten our steps upward toward you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Again, we thank you for joining us this way in Mass, and we have begun to come today to celebrate the daily Masses now at 12:10 each day, Monday through Friday, as we typically have done in the church, since we have had to keep now the churches closed, even for private prayer, under the latest restrictions. So we look forward to broadcasting this each day to you, Mass each day to you, and we pray that you will spread the word and continue to join us as even we all endure the various stresses and restrictions that this pandemic is bringing upon us. Again, remember that also each Sunday at 10:30 a.m. we will broadcast the Sunday Mass, and each Wednesday evening at 7:30 p.m. the recitation and praying of the Rosary. Also, we'll continue to give all this information in our email blasts and websites, but we plan to have the praying of the Stations of the Cross on Friday, either at 7 p.m. So just keep it in contact with the various media that you have, the email blasts, the website, the Facebook page, so that you can see the up-to-minute changes that we have. Thank you again. Also, music minister Brian, we really put this all together. Elected today, Raul, one of our cantors in the wings there, Gretchen and Mike are helping us behind the scenes so that we can bring a bit of the parish church to you again each day until we can all be this together. So we pray for you.
Thank you.